It's such a joy to be with you in this service. Even as we look back, God has protected us throughout this year, right? Has provided us. And He's also promoted us, progressing. This year has been a good year. That's what I can say, all of us can say. In the midst of so many things that have happened, yes, we can happily say, I'm thankful. How many of you can do that? We have a lot of reason to be thankful than to be sad. Amen. Glory to the Lord. Brother, can you raise my voice a little bit more? Little bit more. Check. So I will worship you with all my heart. I will seek your face all through my life. I will serve you, Lord, with all that I have. Here I am. So I will worship you with all my heart. I will seek your face. Serve you, Lord, with all that I have. Here I am. You are my refuge. You are my refuge, O Lord. You are my fortress. You are my friend in need. Yes, you are my Lord. I will worship you. So I will worship you, sing with me, with all my heart. I will seek your face all through my life. I will serve you, Lord, all that I have. Here I am. Shall we just stand up to our feet, sing this song? So I will worship you. So I will worship you with all my heart. I will seek your faith all through my life. I will serve you, Lord, with all that I am. Here I am. You are my refuge. You are my refuge, Lord. I will worship you. So I will worship you with all my heart. I will sing your praise all through my life. Yes, I will serve you, Yes, tell him, I will worship you. Yes. Yeah. I will worship you with all my heart. I will sing your praise all through my life. I will serve you, Lord, with all that I have. Here I am. Here I am. Here I am, Lord. Oh, I am here. Take me and use me, oh God. Yeah. Yeah. Father, we look back into this year, all kinds of things. In the midst of everything, you walked with us, you carried us. Right under your wings, we found safety. We are thankful, Lord. We are thankful. Oh, thank you, Lord. For your protection, oh God. Oh, yeah. If not for your grace, your mercies, and your love, we could not have come this far. Yes, Lord, we mean it from our heart. You are my everything. To the Holy One.
To the Holy
One. Oh, give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Thank you. long. Praises to your name, oh Lord, praises to your name, oh Lord, yes Lord, Lord, yes. To be praised, your name is greatly to be praised, the name above every name. I give glory to your name. Oh Lord, glory to your name. Oh Lord, just tell him your name, for your name. Praises to your name, oh Lord, praises to your name, praises to your name, for your name is great, 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 great. We sing glory. Wonderful, just sing him, sing to him. Father, we are thankful to you. To be praised. Just take a few moments. Just think about it. Some of the people have not seen this day, our loved ones sometimes. But God has kept us safe in the palm of His hand. Just think and give him your clap offering, your thanks. Lift up your holy hands and say, God, it's because of you. It's because of you. Nothing else. It's not of my carefulness. It's only because of you, Lord. You said, though I walk in the valley of darkness, shadow of death, I fear no evil. Because the Lord, and you always said you are with us, Father. You said, when you walk through the fire, I'll be with you. When you go through the waters, you'll not be drowned. Because I am with you. You are the greatest gift. You're the greatest gift of my life. Oh, thank you, my God. Just tell him, thank you, my Lord. You are my Father. You are my everything to me. Oh, how can I give thanks, Lord? There's so much you've done, Lord. More than what I could even think or believe or ask you. Much bigger things you've done in our lives, Lord. It's because of your faithfulness. Your faithfulness is what we put our faith on. Faithful God, you are so good. Faithful One, so unchanging. Ageless One, Ageless One, you're my me. You are my rock. Days ahead of us. We are going to see financial overflow in our life. Though it may not be so with the world, but for us, God's children are taken care of in a very special way. Even God, we tell you, we obey you, Lord. We will trust you, Lord. We want to be serious in the love we have for you. Because you've always been so good to us. We don't deserve, but you give us. Even before praying, Lord. Because the daddy, papa, you care for us. We want to tell you, Lord, before we go from this end of this year into the new year, we want to tell you, you have been so good to me. Yes? Just tell him, you have been so good to me. You have been so good to me, more than I desired. How can I give thanks unto this, Lord? You have done great things, Lord. You have done great things. Thank you, Lord. Please be seated. It's okay. How can I say thanks? That is really is my situation in my life. When I look back, God has been so faithful. Many disappointments have come. Those disappointments have never made me, by the grace of God, bitter. God has given me a victory. Though I have not forgotten it, but that has not gone into. Because always the Lord has come through. When people let us down, when sources let us down, your own investments can let you down. But God says, put your trust in me. More than anything, I'm there for you. Amen. That is what recently I've seen for the past 6 months, because day before yesterday was my daughter's reception, wedding. She got married and the reception was done. But I can only look back and say, because I stored up little by little for my daughter's wedding over many years, and I gave it to some man of God who was doing some investment. But he couldn't help. He had to go and stay some other country, because what he planned didn't work. He is not a criminal, no. He's a good man. But good men also can, their foot can slip. So I will always say, he's not a cheat, but he is helpless. So I go to the Lord and say, now what do I do? You know? Then the Lord said, don't put your trust on the money that you invested. Trust in me. I'm able to see you through. And I want to tell you, whatever I planned for my daughter, 3 times God helped me to spend. And I told my son, after we do the reception, we won't say, pah, we somehow scratched and finished everything God's grace, but I'll have more than that abundantly. And the Lord has kept my word of my prayer. My son knows that. So I'm here to tell you how our Father cares for us. Amen. See, this is a particular area. 2 years back, you know, I went through that COVID stuff and still alive. God brought me out. So that's a different story of an experience of a miracle. So in life, different shades of things come, but all of those things come to stretch our faith, to become more strong, to become more faithful, to see the goodness and the greatness of God. So this today I want to share something very, very simple, but it can be a very prophetic message, okay? What is that, you can say? See, next year, how it's going to be. Many people predict. Okay, let them predict, nothing wrong. Sometimes whatever they predict will never happen. But one thing will always be sure. In this life, next year can be very difficult, one person may say. It's also partially true. Let it be that. But for you and I, we are not against prediction. The world will predict a lot of things. The finance is going to go this way, that way, it will be terrible. New pestilence will come, new this will come, all chaos, disorder. Now, what does it mean for me and you? It doesn't mean anything. You know why? You and I are going to fix our eyes. Who is with us? What's happening outside is a different story. If the Lord Jesus is not with you, then you can be afraid. If the Lord says, I'm going to be with you, child, Whatever happens, I am with you. Then what more you need? See, that is the secret of this year going through that. One thing our faith is, that is what will make you, even though it will become very dark, dark. That's what the Bible says. It will become dark, but gross darkness will cover the earth. But my glory will shine on you. Outside it can be dark, dark, darker, darkest, whatever you call it. But on you, that's what matters. What are you going to focus? What is going to happen there or what is going to happen on you? Now you have to choose. God says, my glory will arise on you. That means when God's glory will come upon us and stays on us, we will have a different provision. We will have a blessed life. You will have beautiful, in the times of disaster and economic crisis, you will buy new things. That is the time you will buy a new car. People ask, what is this? People are losing job. You are starting a business. All those things, no? Totally opposite from what? So the people cannot predict what is happening to us. See, when the people of the Egypt were, they were chasing the Israelites, they were, Israelites were hardly 50 feet also maybe. But these guys cannot see because a dark cloud came in between them. Though they may be as close as this wall, they were thinking they are far away. See, that is what the worldly people cannot see, what you see. What you see, these are people who are under the cloud of God's glory. For us, it is going to be a warm, heater during the coldest nights of the desert. At the same time, in the hottest afternoons, noon, daytime, going to be a shade, like umbrella, pillar of, it's a soothing shadow shade for us. So if this is the technology what God is doing, you better change your thinking. If you think like others, you will simply weep when your Jacob is still alive, Joseph is still alive. Jacob was weeping, thinking he's dead. He was pining, which was unnecessary. When your safety is ensured and God is with us, why should you think about other things and tell this is that one? Don't listen to all the predictions, because the guy who predicts must also give us some money telling, help you. He doesn't help us. He simply talk. But God says, I will be with you. Whatever happens, sister, today, as we move into the new year, I want you to turn your attention to Genesis 26, 1 to 5. Can you turn with me? And take this lesson deep to your heart. Not only for this year, even for the next year, till you die, all the years. It's so beautiful, no? How the Lord has kept all these things for us. 26, anybody wants to read? And, can I read? Can I start reading? Everybody take in Genesis 26, okay? And there was a famine in the land beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of Philistines, unto Gerar. Okay. So now what has happened? Famine. Famine means what? Economic crisis. All the problems put together. No food for the cattle. No food for your children. It's absolutely, it's a hell on earth. Okay. That is a famine. We have not seen famine actually. There are countries that have seen famine where, like Korea, they will take the bark on the tree and they just strip all those things on and pour water and make soup to survive. That's how all people started to eat everything that moves also, to survive. Famine. So famine is not a very happy situation. So when a famine comes, you're out. That's why people panic how to survive. So here, the Lord is telling something. The Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down into Egypt. Dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. That means the people started to think which can be the greener pasture, better to run, go take, better perspective, go there. So they started to run to Egypt. Egypt in those days was like the US. Okay, you go there, the land of blessings, you can come up, and everybody thought that's the best. And nothing wrong, no, because Jesus himself, no, when he was, had to run away from Herod and go and take shelter in Egypt. So going to Egypt is not a sin or whatever I'm saying, okay? Even a lot of people have to go there. But here for Isaac, what is the Lord telling? Telling Isaac, God said, you do not go. Don't go down to Egypt. Stay where I tell you. Stay here in this land of famine. That is, the land is not good, but you stay here. I'll be with you and bless you. Now what you're catching is, I will be with you and bless you. Come to a point telling, I don't care what is happening around. If God is going to be with me and bless me, that's fantastic. Do you agree with me, brother? My dear brother, listen, no. Every one of you, it's a very good news. How do you prepare yourself to face the new year? See, new year can come with different news, okay? Learn to say, this is the best news. The Bible is the current news, okay? Yesterday rain came, right? That is 30th, after the wedding reception. And the guy says, I'm very sorry, I did not know. I was unable to forecast. The guy is telling, at least he's very frank. He's telling, there was no clue of it. But it started to pour cats and dogs. No? And I tell you, I was on the road. I was supposed to go somewhere. Then I thought, maybe my car will get drowned or something. The situation is so worse. It's pouring so hard. On the street, you see, all the big shops are there. The water is up to the pavement. In a short time, no, it to fill up so much. So in 15 years, it's never happened like that. That's what the weather forecast man is telling. Whatever he says, I tell you, people cannot predict some things. They cannot predict. But what does the Lord say? Whatever happens, prediction, let it be there. Sometimes it can be an entertainment for you. Okay. But what God foretells prophetically is not just a story. It's a promise of God. We need to live by the promises of God. My friend, I'm telling you, I've gone through a lot of situations in life, okay? When I look back, you know, my daughter died, no, when she was young. After third day, she came back alive. My son was diagnosed with one in a million sickness, and survival is zero. Nobody. But God made him to run sports. A child who couldn't sit by himself. Just imagine. So I'm not bragging. I can only be grateful to tell. No, I've seen that. Gone admitted in the hospital. They said finished. You're ready for a surgery. But I told the Lord, I don't like that. They said you got a stone so big. The next scan they said 2 stones are there. My wife said, shall we take another? I said 1, 2. Another will be 3 stone. I don't know. Went into prayer. But the Lord, you know, He gave me a promise. Those who contend with you will become as nothing. You will search and not find. It will become a thing of naught. That is, it will not exist. The third time when they took for a scan, they said there are marks, it has been there, but we don't know where. It's not existing. See, that is what God says. I told this report before itself, I got it from God. You will search and not find. It will become a thing of naught. I don't see anything, the surgeon was telling. See, what I'm trying to say is, we have a God who's a miracle God. Amen. Don't ever think baby Jesus in the cradle. No, He's a great and awesome God. And He's so clever, He has made a spiritual thing called the heart, the spirit part of it. Nobody knows what that is. Even many religions, they only talk about the body and soul. They don't even know there's a spirit. The spirit is the eternal part of it. That means no space, time. The spirit can contain such a huge God inside. You got the point? So that's where He dwells. So God comes and dwells. All these things, no, science don't know. But the Lord God is with us. His plan is to be with us. Right from the beginning, He wants to be with us. Adam, He went and spoke to Adam every day to fellowship and talk to him. But you know what happened? Because of sin, we lost. But He came. Okay, in Moses' time, He tell them to make tabernacles. And then He says, make me one right in the center so that I can also live with you. What a desire. He doesn't need this useless piece of a tent. But He says, keep my presence, will want to be with you. And that didn't stop there. Finally, he said, I'll better come and then come and indwell in you. So God, not only with us, God became in us. Are you with me, my dear young person? First understand your value and your worth and your strength. You are not an ordinary person. If you have God inside you, you are somebody different. You are a spiritual person and God dwells. So this idea has always been given. That's why he says, I abide in you, you abide in me. Both of us live. So we have the Lord in us. So we are not afraid of what is happening around us. We don't need to worry. The Sunday school song is always fresh. When Christ is in the vessel, I can smile at the storm. Do you know that song? When Christ in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. Smile at the storm. Smile at the storm. With Christ in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. Sailing, 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 sailing. Yes, sailing. When Christ in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. And we go sailing. See, Sunday school songs are very deep. Lot of Sunday school stuff are very deep. Lot of things that you learn in that UKG, LKG, first standard, the stories are very, very deep. I've always found. Even the stories about, you know, there'll be few cows maybe. Then one lion comes. Then they try to split them by the fox. Divide and then we finish here. What a deep. Together we stand, divided we fall. Where did you learn? When you did your PhD? No. But we didn't take it serious. Then you have a crow. It's got one donut vada. Then the fox comes, says, you're so beautiful. Very excited. And started to, please sing one song. Your voice is so good. So the crow started to sing. And what the crow had went off. The fox ran away with the vadai. Now what is the story? You think it's nice, but do you see the depth of the meaning? How the devil comes to take what you have. He can flatter and make your head grow big and then you lose everything. Simple. All the basic things for kids, what they've learned, we have to learn it again. With an enlightenment, we will avoid a lot of trouble. So this Sunday school song, what a truth, no? When Christ is in the vessel, we can smile at this. You just tell, when Christ is in the vessel, I can smile at 2022. Simple as that. I can smile. Because God turns everything good for me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And we walk in humility. That is a secret. So my friend, you see, Lord appeared unto him and said, "Go, don't go to Egypt. Dwell in the land." Because the general view is you better leave this place and go off there and you will survive. But God is telling, don't go be in the famine. Why? Why does he say, don't go be here even in the midst of? Because it is not your circumstances and surroundings that determine your future. It is God who determines that you will bear fruits even in the famine. And he says, you stay there because you obey me. What will happen? You see what happened finally in verse 12. Verse 12 of Genesis 26. It says, then Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year an hundredfold blessings, and the Lord blessed him. So my dear sister, when the Lord blesses you, he can bless you hundredfold in wherever you are. It is not the surroundings, it's not the location. It is not only if you go to Germany or England or America, you'll become a rich. You can be here and God can help you to possess a house. But do you have that faith? It's easy for God. But the problem is the faith to trust. Before everything, you cancel it because of your thinking. You, when I say it's human beings, we cancel because our brain has learnt a lot of information which causes doubts and unbelief. So doubts and unbelief will not allow God to do mighty miracles in our life. Like a baby, if you just simply take the verse and believe it. Don't try to analyze and try to say, no, in those days it happened, now it won't happen. Definitely, according to your words, it will never happen. But there are people who say, God said it, it will happen, it will happen. It will happen. My son and I, in the night, we will pray together. Because to do a wedding, and I tell you, it's not ordinary. Even my engagement, we did in the seashore because of the restrictions. Then all these things when we did, we may not have money, but both of us will pray in the night. By the time we pray, kick, you see, somebody sent 1 lakh. I say, my son, the 1 lakh is nothing. But if you would learn to have that faith, that is better than 100 lakhs. Because tomorrow you have to face only because of faith. See, faith is the substance for the things. So it will flow into you. And God is very excited when one of his children trust him like a child. He says, oh, this girl is trusting me. I cannot afford to let her down. That's what Hebrews 11:6 says, no? They that come to him must believe that he is, and he is the rewarder of them that diligently seek. Like a child, you must ask. Even, I tell you, finance, all those things, God is going to bless us in a very abundant way. And then what happens, see, you think most difficult times are coming, people may say. But he said, you do what I say, be here, I will bring money. That's what he told me. My friend could not give back my money. Till now he has not given back the money. But the Lord says, you don't put your faith on that money your investment or whatever. Where is your faith? Put it on me. Hallelujah. This lesson also, I learned it in 1990 when I went to Bangkok. Bangkok, for the first time. See, as a young person, I have not even gone on my own to Bangalore. I was a only child, so they kept me. So they sent me for a conference. So I went there first time in my life with $350. That was mandatory, you must carry. Okay, so that's why I carry. And then in that big conference, they were taking offering. So I went and I searched for the least, smallest denomination and trying to tell God, I have 3 months to survive. And put. Then again, the Lord's telling me, you can put more. I said, how can I put more? I'm 3 months, who will feed me? Then after 3 months, who will feed you? The Lord said, for the rest of your life, will this $350 going to come to me? So now, might as well trust me now. So I went again, took some more money, chased after that guy, and put the offering. Tremendous peace came into my heart. He taught me to trust God. You know, when you trust God, he will never leave you. But to trust God is a battle sometimes. But start doing it with small things. Even trust God. When you give your offering to the Lord, it's not for the man or for anything. We are giving to God. And tell God, you know, it's because I love you. And just put it inside. Whatever the biggest note or whatever you have. And I tell you how he will supply your needs. And I want to tell you, my friend, for many years, I've been giving my tithes offering, that is 25% I will give. See, even if some church, when I come, they give me an offering, 25% will go. So if somebody gives me 1,000, what will be remaining? So that's it. And I used to wonder, it is not working like casino, no? I put something, comes fast, it's not coming. I want to tell you, my daughter's wedding, I saw abundantly God is faithful. See, I need it when I really need it. I don't need it when I don't need it. Correct? And this is the really difficult situation. But overflowing, financial explosion. You understand? And people asked me, you must be very busy settling all. I said, no. Few weeks back, even months back, I gave the full payment to people, the caterer, everything. Not just the last minute. You keep it. It's better you keep it than I keep it. And my trust is like that. Just give to them. Everything went on well. What I'm trying to say is, I never saw that amount of money. I've been living mouth to, hand to mouth existence. I'm thankful. But when the need came, God did so much abundantly. So what I'm trying to say is, it's an awesome God. I don't know what to say. That is what I've seen. The same thing is the promise for you and I. Like Moses, he said, if you're not coming with us to the promised land, I don't want. As we go to this new year, just tell the Lord, Lord, my trust is you. I have nobody. That's my prayer. When I'm going from 2021 to 22, hold my hand, Lord. And please lead me and stand by me. If you're going to stand with me, I can face any situation. Even the worst of the worst, and I'll come back alive. Even if they throw me in the desert, I'll come back alive. Nothing will happen if you're there with me. If you're not there, then I have to manage. That is very stressful. By the grace of God, during this marriage, I was not stressful. I was on the reception. I didn't go to the ground to examine. I just let everything went on well. My friend, there is something called resting in the Lord. Correct? Resting is not sleeping, no? You can work and still have a rest. That's why the Lord says, you enter my rest. But these people never entered the rest of God because they lost their faith. Faith in His word, faith on His faithfulness. So, and He talks about His father, Abraham. And He says, how beautifully. And this guy is, let me finish it, verse 12, 13, 14. Isaac sowed in the land and received in the same year an hundredfold, and the Lord blessed him. Hundredfold blessing is possible. I'm seeing that. You won't get it from the bank. Bank, no chance. But there are ways God can give you hundredfold blessing in the same year. Okay? And you see, and the man waxed. What does it mean? He waxed means he became big and strong and grew. And waxed great. What is the real meaning of waxed? He grew, prosper. How many of you want to say, I want to grow? 2022, I want to grow financially. I want to grow spiritually, in my health, everything I want to grow. Because God says, this man, he waxed great and went forward. He didn't go backward, forward. Improving, okay? And grew until he became very great. Finally, he became a threat. The Philistines and all the people, they were envying him. And then what has happened? For he had possessions of flocks and possessions of herds and great store of servants, and the Philistines envied him. My friend, people start envying you. God can bless us such a way, he will envy. People will envy. And then the enemies, they come to him in verse 28. And they said, we saw certainly that the Lord was with you. My friend, now this is a beautiful lesson I'm learning. People will see the greatness of God manifest, which they cannot deny. How many calls after the reception? They said, truly God has been with you, brother, after the rain. The next day was horror. The previous day was different. That means God has been. In your life, I want to tell you, people see the way God is blessing you, protecting you, promoting you, and they will get envy spirit and jealousy. It's okay. But what is that is, things will happen. They'll see the greatness of God manifesting, which they cannot deny that it's God. They'll say, unless God, this couldn't have happened. How many of you want to say, Lord, make me like a banner, make me a miracle, make me a wonder. I'm a wonder in this world because Jesus himself, his name is wonderful. So this year is going to be a blessed year because of our attitude and our mindset. We can face anything. So my friend, your thinking and your talking is very important. Now, as I talk to you all these things, you and I must know one thing is our thinking. Our thinking is what the devil will attack. But make sure you will think and what God is going to do. your thinking now, what I've told you, you understand and make it your thinking. My God is with me. I'm holding him. He will do everything for me. I will obey. To Isaac, the Lord is telling, I'm going to bless because of Abraham. Your children will be blessed because of Abraham's obedience. So our children must be blessed because of our obedience. And your wealth will increase because you will give to your offsprings. So that is true. It will happen. Right now you may not have money. I'm telling you, don't look at your present situation. Suddenly God can do great things in your life. Because you heard people preach also God of suddenly. No? Suddenly it will happen. Even I didn't have faith. Now blindly you must have faith. How it will happen, I don't know. But he will do. Suddenly. Remember not the former things, says the Lord. Behold, I will do something new. It will spring forth. Suddenly it will come. So God loves you. It's not a magic that I'm teaching you. God loves you, sir. And he knows we have failed. Abraham also failed. How many times? Even Isaac also spoke lies. But that's a different story. So that doesn't give us a license to go speaking lies to everyone. You understand, no? Because you and I must have a heart. Lord, I want to please you. If Abraham sinned, let him sin. But I don't want to sin. I want to please you. I want to bring glory to you. I want to be like Job, that God can say, hey, Satan, see my son. You tempt him also, it never will happen. He will win. See, God could, what shall I say? God can bid on that horse, telling it will win. And the horse won. Right? And the Satan lost. Now God must be ready to bid on me. My son, my daughter, she'll be faithful. You know, faithful. Even sometimes, no, we need to go by God's ways. Sometimes, you know, I'm learning even today how this man went on digging wells. They came to strive. He never fought. Okay, keep it. He went. But he became so huge, you know, finally they have to come and fall. Even sometimes people strive. Some people, you know, after you finish the bill, they will come and say 5,000 rupees like this. I can argue. I can threaten. You can do anything. But I've decided 5,000 is very unlawfully you are asking. But I'm going to give you to put an end to strife. Why? I'm going to become great and great and great like Isaac. I don't want to strive for 10,000 rupees, 5,000 rupees. I made up my mind. Otherwise, I'm very good at arguing and fighting. Okay. But now I'm changed from yesterday. Telling you strive, I know, is I am right, you are wrong, but still I will give you. Why? I know because of that I am going to become great, 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 so great, having my peace. My friend, what is your mindset even as we go through the next year, as we are going through? Hold on to the Lord and say, God, I'll go by your... See, this is one kind of obedience. So why do I say I'm not going to strive? Unlawfully you ask me 5,000 when I started booking the place. Now suddenly when you see everything, you want more. Okay. Take that. God will give me 50 lakhs. What is 5,000? Nothing. Now the attitude, no, God is going to bless me. Like Isaac. When you read, see, I'm blessed. I will give it nothing. I don't want to behave very cheap. Take it. Even though you're wrong, I'm not going to take it and go. And God is going to bless. That's what you see in Isaac's life. He's digging, they're coming and arguing. Then he's leaving that for them and going somewhere. Again they come, he dig, and the water comes. And he says, okay, keep it and go. Finally those people are falling at his feet, telling, you're too big. We've seen God is with you. Please don't do any harm to us. That is the way God will lift us up. That is a spirit of meekness. No, see, all the secrets of obedience, if you don't follow, and simply take one promise and claim, no, I don't want you to be disappointed. We must obey God and try to change our ways and align. And this 2022, I tell you, 2022 will be a beautiful year. I'm telling you, why? Not I'm predicting. Even 2022, 23, 24 also. This is the secret. My God will go with me. I will hold on to my God. Simple as that. And I can face anything. I can face any storm, any situation, and you will be blessed even in the situation of famine. Even in the famine, whatever you do, but listen to God, no? Suddenly God, I'm telling you, God will give you opportunities. Whatever you have never experienced till now. So whatever you experienced till now is not everything. God has got more always. He's got millions of ways to bless you. You and I will know only two ways. When you see others do, we think that is the only way. He's got millions of ways. So you tell God, you know how to bless. Who cares how you will bless? But you will bless. I trust you. Your ways are so high. I'm your child. I'm your child, and I want to be. So when you do that in your life, make up our mind to say, I'm going to stay in faith. Whether it's health, okay, whether it's finance, whether a promotion, whether anything that you desire, in this world you'll get it because you believe that He will do it. And I tell you, and now you believe by thinking on the word, and your mouth must speak that. Keep speaking. Keep speaking. It looks like funny, but speak. But at the same time, close for wrong words, negative words. Don't speak negative words. Be cautious. Sometimes it will come till here, you choke it and send it back. Go. But speak only positive according to the word of God. And I'll tell you, God is going to do more than what you think or ask or even believe. Mighty things. But we need to align. So our thinking, our belief system and our mouth is very important. And you will suddenly see things happen in your life. As you are just praising God, thanking Him. Because you lift Him up. See in the Bible how they will sing songs. Like for example, Miriam, Hannah, all those, Mary, all of them, heart is full of gratitude and joy overflowing. And they say, God, you did something. That is the way. Not just singing one song and thinking we have finished our praise. No. Let that heart overflow with gratitude and hope. My God, you will do it. What you've done in Abraham's life, you're going to do it. What you did in somebody's life like Jacob, Joseph, whatever, no. Claim it. Claim the promises of God. And always cause yourself to be thankful. Even though you are praying for something and it has taken a lot of time. I'm telling you, certain things will take a lot of time. It won't happen. But all the things that have already happened, think about that and become grateful. Okay? When you become like that, this will automatically manifest. Amen. So I just want you to just close your eyes with me for a moment. I have just another 4 minutes, okay? 4 minutes. If somebody on the keyboard, my friend, just hold a chord for me. Somebody on the keyboard. Thank you, sir. Just some pad. You're good at it. Thank you. We have a beautiful future. Amen. How many of you believe that? Just say that. I have a beautiful future. My future is, my tomorrow will be better than today. I'm going to see greater things happen in my life because my trust is in the Lord. My hope is in the Lord. You're my only anchor, Lord. You're my only foundation. Just lift up your hands, my dear friends. Today, whatever your burden, throw it away. Just lift up your hands if you want to get stand up. Yes. Just stand up to your feet, lift up your hands and say, God, you're my Father. Tell Him. Just repeat whatever. Say, God, you're my Father. I have nothing in my life. I cannot trust anybody. Even when everybody fail me, my Papa will not fail me. And my trust is in you, Lord. You are there for me. I don't have any worry. Whatever I hear from the world, I don't believe it. I only believe your word. You said, don't go to Egypt to obey you. Then you said, there I will bless you. And you blessed hundredfold. So Father, I pray I will listen to you. Prosper me. Bless the works of my hands. You are a God with open arms accepting me. Tell Him. You are a God with an open hand to bless me abundantly. Oh, you are there for me. You are there for me, Daddy. That is more than enough. Whatever I desire, you are there to give it. Whatever I ask you and desire, when I delight myself in you, I delight myself in the very fact I have a father. I am not a fatherless child. I am not an orphan. I am not helpless. But I have my Papa with me. You said, I will never leave you. I will never leave you, but I'll be with you. This is the secret, Lord, of Isaac. You said, I will be with you and I will bless you. I will be with you and I will bless you. So even as we go through this new year, you are with me and you will bless me. What do I fear, Lord? I thank you. I thank you and I want to tell you I love you. I love you. Just take little time to tell him your love. How much you love him in your own ways. Just tell him, sister, brother, just thank him. Thank him that he has brought us this far. And he will also carry us through. And as we trust and put our faith, I'm going to see great things. I'm going to see abundant financial explosion. I'm going to see miracles, Lord. My Father God, you will do miracles in my life. You will open new doors in my life. So this is my faith in you. My Papa God, you said, I will be with you and I will bless you. Thank you for that, Lord. Thank you. Just thank him for those 2 words. Thank you for telling, I will be with you and I will bless you. Just take a little time to thank him. Sister, open your mouth. Thank him. Thank him. Lord, I thank you because you told, I will be with you and I will bless you. You will bless me 100-fold. Wherever I am, whatever situation, but it is the Lord who blesses me. It is not the government, it is not the surroundings situation, but my God who can turn the water into wine. So Father, we thank you for this word and we move holding your hand and you hold our hand. Make us great possessor of blessings, Lord. Thank you. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Yes. Yes. Let your anointing come upon your people, Father. Heal every body that needs a touch. Right now, Father, every body that is discomfort, I command you, every discomfort to leave that body in Jesus' name. And a financial breakthrough in their life. Father, I pray for your people. They will experience a new joy in relationship with you. They will want to spend time with you. And they will connect with you. And bless them, Father. Bless them as never before. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Why don't we clap our hands and bless the Lord. And bless dear brother Isaac Joe and his team and his family all who have come. God will definitely do great and awesome things in your life. Each and every day, the Bible says in Psalm 118 verse 24, this is the day the Lord has made. So each and every day of your life, God has made it for you. So use it to the best. There is no bad day for those who follow Jesus Christ. All you have to do is connect with him and make him the Lord of your life and of that day. And everything will work out beautiful. Oh, the things which God has prepared for those who love him. The Bible says, eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard, neither has entered into the hearts of men. The same will happen in your life. God wants you to be witnesses for him. So he's looking for people whom in he can invest in, whom he can use to show forth his glory. And these are the days of glory for the people of God, for the church of Jesus Christ. When the world might be in darkness and doubt, the people of God will be stronger. Oh, they'll prosper even more and be in much more good health. Amen. Oh, yes. See you all outside. God bless you. Have a great night. See you on Sunday morning. Amen.